Hi, I'm Gloria Strode, and welcome to Straightforward. It is that time of year again, the Phenix City Whitewater Classic. And last year, those Albany State Golden Rams took home the victory. So this year, Tuskegee University has something to prove. We have two great new presidents, President Frederick and President McNair. We are looking for you all to come. We're going to have an awesome time. And Christy Collins is here to share with us all the fabulous events, the 2018 Whitewater Classic.
It'll be hosted by the Power 25. We're really excited about that. It's something new. We usually have a concert, but this year we thought if we did something for the young professionals to come out, we open up tailgate so early. So just so give some people something to do, and then they can go on to their football games or whatever else they have planned for Friday night.
Okay, and so where is that event for your young professionals?
At the Ida Hour Community Center as
well. Okay, all right. Is that free?
Yes.
Okay, so that is free. Mm-hmm. It's open to the public. You want the young people to come network. Mm-hmm. If they're already working, if they own their own businesses.
Definitely.
Because we have a lot of mm-hmm. young professionals that are business owners.
That's right.
And so that way, not only can they meet other young professionals, but they can promote their business.
That's right.
And it's free.
That's right.
Because it costs a lot of money to promote your business.
That's for real.
It really does.
Right.
Okay, and so with the college fair, you're going to have more recruiters other than the Albany State University and the historic Tuskegee University.
That's right.
So you're going to invite other
mm-hmm.
colleges.
We invite Chattahoochee Valley, Southern Union, of course the military, sometimes
Troy.
We've mm-hmm. had Auburn before. It's just a matter of just people exploring their options and just letting them know that they're, even if you can't go to a 4-year, you can go to a 2-year, mm-hmm. or maybe even the military may work for you, and then they can pay for your college. It's just so many options out there. People have just got to go and get the information. It's not just going to find you.
Exactly. And the good thing about Positively Phenix City, you have a 2-year, mm-hmm. which is if someone wants to get an associate's, mm-hmm. you have Chattahoochee Valley, mm-hmm. so they can go there for 2 years, and then once they get the associate's, they can go over to Troy mm-hmm. University,
that's right.
which is right there on the river, mm-hmm. and continue. And so that is the great thing. And then they are really located pretty close. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not like you got to drive 25 or 50 mm-hmm. miles. To do that.
Right.
And a lot of times junior college, as we used to call it, but community college is really more affordable.
That's right.
Because you're not having to worry about what? Dormitories,
mm-hmm.
we call
food
it room
plans,
and board,
right.
and all of that, which can be very pricey.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So I agree with you. They need to come out and check their options.
Right.
Sometimes the parents don't know.
Right.
So the recruiters are going to help them with information like mm-hmm. learning how to fill out your FAFSA, mm-hmm. which is your financial aid.
That's
you
right.
have to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Taking the SAT or the ACT,
mm-hmm.
you know, we have some bright kids
That's
in,
right.
you know, Columbus, over in the Phenix City area, but we need to make sure they have all the information,
right.
all the tools,
right.
so they could possibly become a graduate of the Albany State University or the historic Tuskegee University, but whatever it
That's
is.
Right.
We want to make sure that we get that information.
And preparation is the key to that. Unlike college and, you know, going to regular school, you can't just decide, mm-hmm. you know, that you're just going to go there. It is a process. And like you said, taking those exams, trying to get a decent score, looking at, you know, your financial aid options, room and board options, mm-hmm. Meal plans, all of those things.
Transportation.
Yes.
If you go to a school in California and you live in Georgia, Alabama, mm-hmm. you're going to need an airline ticket.
Right.
You know, so it's all of those things.
Right. In-state, out-of-state fees. It's mm-hmm. a lot of those things. So it's just make sure, and even for your non-traditional students, some of the parents that may want to go back to the school mm-hmm. and stuff, a lot of colleges are offering online things that you can do. And so it's just, and that's what it's just about, taking advantage of those things. And we want to offer that. We want this to be big. And we're very grateful for Bethlehem Baptist Church for heading that up for us.
Well, and I think that's awesome for them too. Our faith-based community to just join in, and because that's a part of educating.
Mm-hmm.
That's a part of the Board of Christian mm-hmm. Education. And you are a graduate of an HBCU.
Of course.
Okay, and
no
what is
way.
The name of that school?
It's THEE, Jackson State University.
Jackson State.
The I love.
So that is where you got your bachelor's.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and so where did you get your master's?
At the University of Southern Mississippi.
Okay, all right. So you've done those two things.
Yeah.
And so being on board, you know, the Whitewater Classic was your original baby, but you've had your own personal baby
That's
since
right.
then. But you've been through the process.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to be there on site, and you can help with coaching people
oh,
if
yeah.
they have questions outside of the recruiters.
That's right.
Because you're a familiar face.
That's
you work
right.
with a lot of the kids because you are the superintendent mm-hmm. of what now?
Of recreation in Phoenix City.
Okay. And so a lot of those kids are your kids.
That's right.
And so they might feel more comfortable with you than someone that they're just meeting for the first time.
That's right. And that experience, I would tell anybody, my HBCU experience taught me so much about life. Granted, Southern Miss was a great experience, but I feel like because of what I learned at Jackson State, I was able to maneuver and be able to network and all those things that you learn mm-hmm. at HBCU dealing with your people. It is just, it's invaluable. I just wouldn't trade that experience
for
anything.
And it's like being a part of a family for life.
For life.
It's you're grounded.
Mm-hmm.
Resources, safety net.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like you are standing on the outside looking in.
No, because everybody looks like me.
Yeah, and it's very much a part of, you're part of a family,
mm-hmm.
and it's a lifelong family,
mm-hmm.
yeah. Well, we're gonna take our first break, go to our sponsors, and then we're gonna come back, and then we're just gonna go all the way through what the game day is gonna look like.
Okay.
All right, we'll be right back after word from some of our sponsors. Straightforward is brought to you by Chalk by Quincy introduces excellence redefined, timepieces of the finest technology, luxury, and class with tons of style at chalklifestyle.com. Renal Associates, LLC, a team of physicians dedicated to excellent kidney care with 5 convenient locations to serve you. Stark Avenue, Columbus, Bradley Park, Columbus, Lafayette Parkway, LaGrange, East Burkhalter Avenue, Buena Vista, and Springs Street in Warm Springs. The Framing Factory and Art Gallery, specializing in quality art and framing for all your needs. Original etchings, limited editions, and prints. Call Carlton Dickey today at 706-324-3823 or visit the Art Gallery at 1325 17th Street in Columbus. Vanessa Jackson's District 3 Successful Scholars Program, supporting students in achieving academic excellence, outstanding citizenship, positive social and cultural growth, believing in success for kids.
Walmart's reason for supporting Thurgood Marshall College Fund is simple. We like to win. And we have been given a lot of exposure to some incredible talent. And we also believe that it's a part of our responsibility to the community to give back. This is a great opportunity to do both. It's been a wonderful experience for us through the years. We've appreciated our partnership. We believe in return on investment, and we have definitely had a remarkable return.
Don't miss the PC Whitewater Classic September 8th as the Golden Rams of Albany State take on the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. Kickoff is at 4 p.m. Central at Garrett Harrison Stadium. Reserve your tailgating spot now online. Visit PCWhitewaterClassic.com for more info.
Come meet your new best friend at Paws Humane.
Adopting from your shelter makes sense. You get a great friend checked by our vet. They're fixed, all shots, microchipped, all ready to make you and your family's life better. 4900 Milton Road, Columbus. Paws Humane.
Come meet your new best friend at Paws Humane.
Welcome back to Straightforward. I'm continuing my conversation with the awesome Christy Collins Goggins, and we are talking about the Whitewater Classic, where the Albany State University Rams won last year.
They did.
So we have something to prove this year.
And you know, you guys had a new coach last year, so it
yeah.
was really, really, you know, a good. Just it was a good momentum, good high. It was
mm-hmm.
it was great. I was very excited. And you know, I love Albany, especially dealing with this game. I love Tuskegee too, but I love dealing with the people from Albany. They're so supportive, and there's a lot of alumni groups, and
mm-hmm.
One comes out of Atlanta, then we have two here in this area. And I just love how the fans of Albany State just come out and truly support the Albany State. I love everything
about
it.
And you've been down to visit our beautiful campus.
Yes.
As I was telling you, a lot of that came about. It was a blessing in disguise. Mm-hmm. Sometimes what looks like a bad thing mm-hmm. really works to your favor. But we had a flood, mm-hmm. but we survived. Mm-hmm. And then we were able to get some newer buildings, but the campus is just simply beautiful.
It is.
It is. And so you've had a chance to go down and visit.
Oh, yeah. The West Campus, I've mm-hmm. been on the traditional campus, but the West Campus is immaculate. Mm-hmm. I was just like, oh wow, like mm-hmm. when I walked in where the financial aid and stuff like that mm-hmm. is, I was very and just the feel of it, it looks, you know, very prestigious, and it looks like it's been taken care of, and mm-hmm. it is great to see a HBCU name in front of it.
Right. Well, when I was there, it wasn't that sprawling and all of that new, but we still loved it just the same. And a lot of where we see the development of the campus was actually rural. It was trees, and yeah, because where the football stadium is, that didn't exist when I was there, and that kind of thing. But it does my heart good, and that is why I'm a part of the Chattahoochee Valley Alumni mm-hmm. Association, and that is why we are so excited, because mm-hmm. for the old school Rams, we've seen it, mm-hmm. and we're so very thankful. Mm-hmm. Albany State is one of the only schools in Georgia that has a major in forensic science.
Wow.
So you could be CSI at the Albany State University.
All right.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. So the teams are going to come in. Mm-hmm. We're going to have game day. So what do we have? Vendors. We got the Kids Village. What do we have again this year?
Of course, we kick off everything at 1 o'clock. So our tailgating opens on Friday night at 4. So people that get their tailgate spots, pcwhitewaterclassic.com. They can get their tailgate spots or visit us at our Parks and Rec office. They're $30. It uh-huh. includes a parking spot with that. So if you come in, you do have a spot to park your car as well. You can
right there with your tailgate spot or near it.
Near it.
Okay,
yes.
near it.
I don't like a lot
of
cars.
You don't want to park it on the grass.
Yeah.
Because that grass you're so proud of.
That's right. And when people get ready to move, they be ready to move.
Exactly.
And you don't want
to block people
yeah,
in.
Yeah,
right.
1,000 people in there. So we start at 4 p.m. People can tailgate all night if they want to. We'll have
on
patrol.
Friday.
Yes.
Okay.
We'll have
security?
Mm-hmm. We'll uh-huh. have patrol in the area that Friday night. We'll continue that. At 1 o'clock, we kick off our everything that goes on, like the kids zone, the barbecue competition. We'll have a space tournament. All of those things will start
Lord,
at 1 o'clock.
No, HBCUs are fabulous for space.
Yes.
So you're having a space tournament.
Yes.
And so where would that be? Down in the mm-hmm.
the community center parking lot near the stage.
Oh my goodness.
Yes.
You know, that's you're gonna need security there. Because people are so serious. You graduated from an HBCU. People would actually, true story, go to eat in the dining room and have somebody hold in their place for the next down. So, I mean, really.
Exactly.
So that is just something. You didn't have that last year,
no,
did you? Oh,
no.
My goodness.
We're just continuing on with the culture, mm-hmm. as we call it. And so we'll have that going on. And that'll go from 1 to 5. Mm-hmm. We'll have Cece the Christian Clown there. She'll be making balloons and stuff for the children. Everything. We always want to foster a great environment where people can come, have a good time. We'll have the bands come down and do a pep rally like we did last year before the game, and then they'll march
up
to the stadium.
And these are the college bands, mm-hmm. right? So the Tuskegee band and the Albany State University
yes.
Marching Rams mm-hmm. show band mm-hmm. will come down, do the little pep rally
yeah.
thing, and then they march back to the stadium mm-hmm. when it's game time.
Mm-hmm. When it's time for the gates to open.
Okay.
So that means we're trying to draw everybody to the stadium. Game time is 5 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, we'll have the Whitewater Classic Old School Block Party where Cupid, the Dance Line King, will be featured.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
The Cupid Shuffle
mm-hmm.
person.
Yep.
Oh, Lord. That's going to be an adventure in itself.
Yes.
So the old and the young people who are those that are young at heart
yes.
will be there doing the Cupid Shuffle.
That's right. We want people to stay all day. We want something all day for people to do. Everything is family friendly. Nothing is too vulgar. Nothing is too out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the thing. We start the night before. You don't have to be in a rush. You know, it's a long day, but it's an enjoyment day. And you don't have to spend a lot of money doing all of this.
Right. It's
most
affordable.
Of it's free.
Mm-hmm. Right. So will you have the vendors again this year?
Of course.
Oh, Lord. The lady with the homemade cakes. She was just
yes,
a bad
was.
Influence on me.
She was right up there by y'all, too.
Yeah, she was. I mean, she had red velvet. lime, she had German chocolate. Mm-hmm. And so every time you walk past her, she was like, okay, you want to get another one? And I'm thinking, you can't eat for a month just after you leave the Whitewater Classic.
That's
yeah.
awesome.
And so your vendors with mm-hmm. the clothes mm-hmm. and all of that, they'll
all
be
all of that, uh-huh, up at the stadium. And it'll be on you guys' side this year because you're all the visitors. So mm-hmm. it'll be that we'll have. I know everybody always talks about the chicken wrap guy we do in our department because mm-hmm. I don't know if it was a long day mm-hmm. or what, but this guy was making these wraps and they were like the best thing we had ever eaten. So we're really excited about the Whitewater Classic, about what we're fostering and just looking forward to a great event with great weather.
And I want, you mentioned Mel and Abe Barbershop. Mm-hmm. Everybody knows them. They are part of an institution in
yes.
that community.
yes.
But they give so much, and they have been sponsors mm-hmm. from day one.
From day one. They mm-hmm. always have sold tickets for us. We honor them, I think maybe in our second year, just for being a part, and we always try to look out for them. And 280 Cuts and Styles, which is a newer barbershop, is mm-hmm. on the other side of town. But those two, no matter what we ask them for, they support. 280 Cuts and Style actually gives away a $280 gift card to Walmart in the game. People have to go in the game in order to find this
really?
Out. Yes, because it's Show Your Style and you hashtag on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, mm-hmm. your picture showing your game day style, and then they randomly choose someone and then you win a $280 gift card to Walmart. So those two have been.
So they are really great community partners.
Yes.
They are, because they understand that if people come to Positively Phoenix City, then it's good for everybody.
That's right.
And, you know, of course, I know Mel and Abe, they've been there for a long time. Everybody mm-hmm. knows them.
That's
They're
right.
really like celebrities.
That's right.
But it's just good to know that you have folks on board mm-hmm. that support this mm-hmm. because all of this is about the kids, mm-hmm. the students, and both universities.
That's right.
So what we're going to do is take our final break, go to our sponsors, and then we'll be right back.
All right.
We'll be right back after word from some of our sponsors. Straightforward is brought to you by Warrior Outreach. Contact Command Sergeant Major Retired Sam Rhodes or Kathy Rhodes. The Hugel Foundation, enriching the community through Christian music support, community outreach, and the Georgia Through Photography Project. For more information, call B at 706-568-6431. Progressive Funeral Home, family owned and operated since 1952. The George Ford legacy of high standards continues today in the compassionate and professional services provided. A touch of dignity for those who care. Progressive Funeral Home, 4235 St. Mary's Road, trusted by generations. Best Care, transforming minds and bodies, leading the way in the latest techniques of medical weight loss and wellness. Certified in family medicine and bariatrics, Dr. Blunt is ready to assist in the transformation of your mind and body. Call today, 706-221-6477, or visit bestcarecolumbus.com. East Alabama Endocrinology, educating and caring for those living with diabetes in Alabama and Georgia. 1400 Bradley Lake Boulevard, 3320 Skyway Drive, Suite 602, Opelika. Take charge of diabetes and live your best life. State Senator Ed Harbison, serving the citizens of Georgia's 15th Senatorial District and on the front line for veterans every day.
Don't miss the PC Whitewater Classic September 8th as the Golden Rams of Albany State take on the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. Kickoff is at 4 p.m. Central at Garrett Harrison Stadium. Reserve your tailgating spot now online. Visit PCWhitewaterClassic.com for more info.
Welcome back to Straight Forward. I'm continuing this awesome conversation with the one and only Christy Collins Goggins from the PC Whitewater Classic.
Yes.
We're excited. I am every year. Your team, you all are awesome. You're well organized and it just run like a sewing machine.
That's
no,
right.
really it is. Of course, I was a little surprised this year that we didn't have the new baby Major with his own golf cart, but you said that's coming next year.
As soon as he can walk, he's
as soon as he can walk, he'll be having his staff t-shirt on. He'll be working as well.
Yes.
Yeah, so last year you allowed me to be a part of the barbecue tasting. Of course, I don't eat pork, so I kind of use my husband as a guinea pig. But that was really fun. Yeah. And people were very, very excited to have the mayor and people taste their barbecue to see who was the king of the grill.
What was so funny, if you see those pictures, Steve Smith, who is our utilities director, but and he used to be over finance. In the pictures, you're with him, but he has his Whitewater Classic hat like up to here, and he has his everything, and he's like licking. It is so funny, and that was just something we kind of came up with just to get people. But you know, last year the weather, it was like a hurricane coming, and so but we had a great day that day, and it was,
didn't get rained on. It really worked
the weather
out well.
Was perfect.
Yeah, and we just had people that would not travel from other places because we had that hurricane.
Right.
So we are looking forward to a cooler. Because the first year it was really hot.
Yes.
And so that's why you moved the time to later.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
It was really in the middle of the day. And it was just kind of whatever. So the teams will be coming in, the coaches. And so what do you all have planned? The presidents of the universities. Of course, you know, we have a new one. Our Dr. Dunning retired and moved on. And we have actually a female. Right. So she's our new president. And does Tuskegee have a female president?
They do.
Wow.
They do.
So we went from Burnett. Two men and got two ladies, two females this year.
Actually, we just met her. We had talked on the phone, but I actually just met her last week, and she's very awesome. She's a HBCU grad. She graduated from Lane and stuff like that. So
I
mean, she has a deep HBCU history. So she's really excited about working with both new presidents.
Yes. And so you normally have a little reception. The mayor and his wife host for just the presidents in the little box upstairs.
Yeah, we allow the home team president to use that area. We get her credentials or him credentials, and they invite whoever they want to invite up and have their hors d'oeuvres and stuff like that, you know, whatever they want to have. So that is something that we have reserved for the home team president. So this year it will be Dr. Burnett from Tuskegee.
Yeah. Well, no, that's very good.
Right.
No, it is. And that way people get to meet and greet some of your administrative staff from both universities, get a chance to chat, of course, and with the mayor and the city manager and your team. I mean, your supervisor is
Todd Hughes.
He's always so very nice to
me.
He's one of my favorites. Yeah. He'll let people ride me in the golf cart and all of that. So,
yeah,
you know, I like that feeling of being a part of the team, even though I didn't get my shirt.
Yeah, we got that this year.
We got that this year in the correct size.
We ain't gonna tell it what size.
We won't tell everybody what size. Okay, so are we having, we're gonna have the Cupid event with the Cupid Shuffle. So how long is that?
That's gonna be probably like a 3-hour show. They're gonna start at 7:30 with some opening acts, some local bands and stuff like that. And then Cupid should come on right around 9 and he'll do like a 90-minute show.
Okay, so is that the stage near
the community center,
the water that you're so proud of, the lake.
Yes.
Okay, so we're not going down to the amphitheater.
No, no,
we're
going
to be, everything is right there on the grounds. So once they park, they can stay from the time they get there until it's all done.
Yes, you will be entertained.
Okay, and so what do you want the community to do? You want them to participate in starting with
supporting. I mean, even if everybody is not a football fan, everybody doesn't want to go in and see the game. Our thing is making sure that we have people in the area. We show up in numbers. We show that we want to be a part of this. Even if you just go to the store and buy gas, even if you just go buy you a six-pack of beer or whatever you do, you know.
It's
just
part of economic
exactly.
development.
Exactly. Because we don't really see a lot of direct impact, you know, numbers from that day. Everything that we have is indirect with our tax dollars and stuff. So we want just people just to come out, be present, and just see what it is and enjoy yourself. Don't try to critique everything. It's still a work in progress. This is only our fifth year. We're really excited about it, and we have grown a whole lot since that first year. So we just want people to come
out. And it's all about supporting the schools and scholarships. And you all have really done well in giving back to both universities.
Oh, yeah. When they're the home team, we do give a significant
donation once you all
clear
everything.
Yes, part of the contract. Yes, mm-hmm. a part of the contract of what we give to the schools for coming over. Mm-hmm. And we make sure that it's beneficial to the schools, you know, for them to come and participate in this game.
So it's not some personal thing that it's all just about Phoenix City making all the money, keeping it, and not giving back.
No.
So this intended to give back, and that way it helps sponsor scholarships. Maybe kids from
whatever
Central,
the schools do,
whatever it is, yeah, it might be helpful to someone, you know.
And bringing exposure to those schools in this area. I know that they have played in this area, but they've never played each other. And some people may not even know about those games. Their families may not participate. But if you're riding up Somerville Road on September the 8th, you will know that something is definitely going on.
Yes, and you can see it from the JRL and Parkway, and you're like, where are all the cars going? So, again, where can they get the tickets? What is it for the tailgating? What is it for the Cupid Shuffle? Because everybody. And what is it for the spades?
Yes.
You know, is all of that free?
Okay.
Quickly.
Everything is free. You can find out all information at PCWhitewaterClassic.com. You can get tickets at Melanie Barbershop, 280 Cuts and Styles, or our Phoenix City Parks and Rec office. Tickets are $15. Pre-sale and on the game day, they're $20. Tailgating is $30. You can come by our office or visit PCWhitewaterClassic.com.
Okay, so the spades contest, because all of the spades, old school spades.
Yeah, okay, so the block party post-game is free, so people just need to bring their lawn chairs, come out, sit, and have a good time. The spades tournament, they can visit PCWhitewaterClassic.com and sign up for that as well.
Okay, and bring their team.
That's
right.
Also,
and we're going to have security there because, you know, people get so serious about those card games.
Oh, yeah. We have like six officers designated for tailgate in that whole area just by itself.
So somebody's going to be watching. Yes. Right. And your Parks and Rec office is located right there near the stadium.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
15.
Give us the name of the stadium again for the people that might be new to the area.
Okay, Garrett Harrison Stadium, and the address to my office is 1500 Airport Road, Phoenix City.
And if you get off there on Somerville, you can just stand that.
Make a left.
Right there, right across from the McDonald's, you will see the stadium with the big Jumbotron.
Yes.
And the AstroTurf.
That's right.
All right. So we're excited. I thank you so much for what you do for the Albany State University and, of course, the historic Tuskegee University. You all are changing lives. You are supporting our beloved HBCUs, and we just can't thank you enough.
Yes.
So people need to be there, be square.
That's right.
All right.
I hear about it.
All right. So Saturday, September the 8th. Phoenix City.
5 p.m.
5 p.m. Whitewater Classic.
That's right.
All right. We'll be there. This has been Straightforward. If you don't stand for something, you will fall for anything. Until next time, be blessed.